everyone. Ian here, and behind me is a new listing of mine in Dana Point, California. This is a 2016 Marlow Hunter 31. So let me show you some of the features and benefits that this vessel has to offer.
Here we are looking at the 2016 Marlow Hunter 31, and there's a lot of incredible features about this particular vessel that I'm going to try to hit on all of the points, but let me take you through a little tour of this yacht. So here we are starting up at the bow. You can see this is a really nice solid stainless steel Lumar Delta style anchor here. We have the Furlex head cell furler. We also have the navigation light, stainless steel bow rail, and it really ties in the lifelines quite nicely. The Marlow Hunter is really known for its quality craftsmanship, beautiful woodwork, great stability and sailing characteristics. One thing I also want to point out is they've actually done the hole to deck joint that is through bolted every 8 inches. So underneath of this rub rail, it's through bolted every 8 inches. We have our inner cap shrouds, our outer cap shrouds here that tie into the vessel itself. So really great sturdy strength and stability. The other thing I like is that these kind of fold down stainless steel cleats here. So when not in use, they fold down and they're not, you know, something that you're gonna get, you know, your toe stubbed on and what have you. Genoa tracks here on the side decks that are adjustable for many different angles here. And coming into the cockpit, you can see for a 31-foot vessel, we're gonna be really impressed what this has to offer. But before we go there, let me take you to the foredecks here. And notice that the Marlow Hunter window just really ties in this beautiful lines that really focus on natural light, you know, entering the salon itself. And as we walk up forward, you're gonna notice that all of the sheets and halyards lead into the cockpit. We also have a two-spreader Selden in-mast furling mast. There's a TV antenna at the very top, wind point, wind speed, obviously anchor light. We also have bird deterrent above each speaker. These are Tuyl sails. And again, this is a really nice system for ease of handling. As we walk up to the foredeck, you're gonna see these nice foldable cleats in action here. So they are a really nice design here, really capturing that line. But we have the anchor windlass itself. This is a electric quick windlass. So this is a electric up and down windlass, a nice anchor locker here. You can see all of the fenders being stowed here. And then a really nice access point here for the anchor itself. We also have a water inlet, and it's just the small attention to detail. These small little things that really kind of stand out is just the access point, you know, how they're all flush here. And it's a beautiful lines. And now the non-skid is just really soft, but yet grippy. And it really just allows a nice overall look. So I'm gonna be taking you back to the cockpit, but we have flush hatches overhead. And there is a door rad there, so it allows the boat to breathe, getting some of that you know, ventilation through the vessel itself. Now, as we come into the cockpit, you can see it is actually utilizing the entire beam of the vessel. So a lot of boats, they'll just kind of cut it off. But what they've done is they've widened that out. They're utilizing the entire beam. And this is an impressive cockpit. For this size of boat, it is really something that I really want to point out some of those other features here. But before I go too far, stainless steel arch, which the Hunter is known for. But when Marlow purchased the company, he really kept a lot of those Glenn Henderson designs and really incorporated it into his vessel. So we have the stainless steel arch, traveler here right on top of the stainless steel arch, and that is the best point right at the end of the boom to control that main. Coming back down, we're gonna kind of look over to the port side here. This is a lazarette locker, a really nice large subwoofer speaker back here. The sound system is really impressive. We have our traveler adjustment and a double-ended main sheet adjustment. So when you unfurl your mainsail and you're back here and you're adjusting your jib sheets and what have you, you're able to adjust your mainsail from right here, which is really, really nice. They've also incorporated the stern rail seats here and this amazing drop-down swim platform. This is so nice. It allows you to gain access into your dinghy or swim off the back of the boat with ease. So that's a nice feature. I lowered it down. Normally when you're sailing, you'd keep it in the upright position, which closes this all in. But now let me get you to some innovation here. And what some of the key points for the innovation of this cockpit are, is you'll see these right here are on hinges, and what do? They kind of fold out, and they actually give people something to really kind of grip their feet on, to have that stability, you know, if you're heeled over and pushing it, depending on, you know, who the captain is. We also have a cockpit table that folds up on both sides, which I really find impressive. And then here at the helm, you're going to see this is your, you know, really nice traditional Lumar folding wheel that opens up on both sides. But look at this Lumar little foot pedal. When I deploy the foot pedal, now I can bring the helm over here. Look at this. You can just imagine what this does for you. So if you're down here sitting and you want to be on the high side or the low side, you have the ability to bring the helm and swing it to both starboard and port side, and also keep it center if you so desire. Really incredible feature here. I really like the innovation. Nicely done. Again, because this cockpit is so large, this enables you to really have that function of, you know, being able to steer from multiple points, locking it over off to one side. Really incredible in my opinion. All right, so bringing this back to normal, stationing this back up, locking it in place, folding up the wheels. This is primarily how you're gonna have it when you're kind of hanging out at the dock. But what we have here is, this is our VHF RAM mic. So we have access point here to the VHF. We also have our Ritchie compass. There's also a Fusion remote control for the stereo. So this is a little remote pad. And I love this, the throttle positioning, because what this offers you is you have really good, easy access to your throttle. And then when you're reversing the boat, you still have great access here to your helm and your throttle. So great location for that. We also have the autopilot. Now this is a wheel pilot, so it's mounted to the wheel. That's what this gray piece is. So this is your Raymarine autopilot, and then this is a chart plotter. So Raymarine chart plotter, autopilot, VHF, everything that you really need in a vessel of this size here at your fingertips, plus some really cool innovation by Lumar and Marlow Hunter here in the cockpit. You also have, you know, storage, lots of seating. Again, the bimini's really high, the arch is really high, so you have tons of headroom here. There are speakers underneath this, so again, incredible stereo system that was put into this vessel. There's an overhead light as well too, and then as we move up forward, we're gonna have the accessibility right here to the engine display. So this allows us to start, stop the engine right here. Shows 25 hours on it, very, very low use. And again, yeah, really nice, you know, cluster. You also have your fuel gauge that popped up when I powered on the system itself. And then you have your high water alarm. So this you can manually turn on, or if you hear that sound, you know something's definitely going wrong. But likelihood of that is next to nothing. And it does give you some really good brownie points with your insurance company. All right, so coming here to the companionway, one thing I want to also notice is look at this low step. So it's easy access into the companionway itself. No big steps up. There's only three steps going down into the salon. Before we go there, I'm also going to show you that we have our depth, our speed, and our wind point wind gauge. So that right there is really easily accessible visually from the cockpit, so everybody can see them. Here off to the port side, we have our furl in, our furl out. This is our sheet here that controls the mainsail, mainly furling it in, our jib halyard, and then our main outhaul, which pulls the sail out, main sheet and main halyard. So again, this is great here. I love how they have these built-in cubby storage areas to really house that. Then we have our jib winches off to the starboard and port side. All right, so coming down below the vessel, you're gonna see the galley is off to the starboard side. This is a really open floor plan. I really love what they've done here. Not to mention the wood, the cabinetry, but the floor plan itself is just so open and inviting. We feel like we're on a much larger boat than 31 feet. And what we have here that I'm gonna start off on the starboard side with is we have our stainless steel sink. Underneath this is lots of storage, two burner stove and oven. And then we have a really nice refrigeration compartments here. You can also thermostat these down to almost freezing or freezing. So it is nice to have a fridge, freezer here. additional outlets. There's a nice little light switch that's brought in there. Overhead opening hatch right above the stove. So this is quite important. And then what I really like, look at these stainless steel grab handles. They really thought of everything. They're wrapped in leather. It's quite nice. And again, a really nice feel. So just facing the aft cabin, we have our water tank gauge here. We have our 110 side. So this allows us to control the 110 power into the vessel itself, and then the 12 volt power here as well. So easy access there. And one thing I want to point out, this boat has air conditioning. So air conditioning, heating is pretty unique for a vessel of this size. But again, look at the woodwork, this beautiful cabinetry that they've done here, and it's quite nice. Well, since we're facing aft, let me take you to the aft cabin. This is a large hanging locker here, storage area. He has dehumidifiers, LED lighting, and then this goes in to this amazing, you know, I would say it's a queen size bed. So a large berth back here. We have the filler cushion for the salon table when it drops down. And then we also have our AC breaker for the incoming shore power there. There's an escape hatch overhead, and then obviously this hatch for ventilation. But again, really nicely done. You're going to see that black air vent over there. That's part of the air conditioning. And then we have access points here, here, and in the front to get access to the engine. Behind this door here, these are our battery switches. So this is showing us our engine start, stop. Pretty much this is just allowing us to turn off the engine battery. We have battery switches for the house battery bank, and this is the Lumar windlass breaker for the windlass itself. But again, beautiful flooring, beautiful cabinetry work. You can just see the attention to detail that Marlow Hunter's done, and it's really important. Okay, so directly across from the aft cabin entrance, underneath the companionway steps, this is access to the backside of the engine, and the sail drive access is right underneath here. So great accessibility to that, and then obviously the front side of the engine. Because of this design, they reverse the engine, almost face it backwards, and put the sail drive here. There's a lot of benefits to that. Take me a little longer to explain in this particular video, but again, it's well done. All right, so looking off to the port side, we have a built-in microwave, additional storage cabinets here, and then we have accessibility into our head shower compartment. So again, I keep on saying this, but for a 31-foot vessel, this is a large shower compartment, head compartment. So underneath this teak grate right here is the shower drain. This is our shower faucet itself. They have a little smoked plexiglass divider, but you can stand up here, you can sit down, and again, take a shower, so it's quite nice. We also have a manual Japsco quiet flush toilet. And then the other thing, this comes down here, so you can sit down and get ready if you so desire. But again, easy access here. Stainless steel sink, Corian countertops. You know, look at the thickness of those Corian countertops. And then there's a mirrored vanity back there and additional storage below. All right, let's move into the salon. So again, the salon, you can see just these large windows, opening hatches, two overhead opening hatches. We talked about the microwave storage, the flat screen television. And then we have an ICOM VHF off to this side, Fusion stereo. This is a really nice upgraded Fusion stereo, all set up with Bluetooth. And then we also have the autopilot remote. So this is a little remote. It's currently plugged in right now, but you can actually take this anywhere with you. Just forward to that are some additional outlets. And as you can see here, he has a Dyson airflow technology, and then also dehumidifier. But again, beautiful windows. There's also curtains that come down and, you know, close this off for privacy. And then we have this large L-shaped seating area here. Beautiful table, which is very, very high gloss, as you can see here. And then really nice materials used on all of the seat cushions. This table does drop down and turn into an additional berth. So that's what those filler cushions were in the aft cabin. All right, so across from us is a bench seating here off to the starboard side. And then we also have the inner chain plates that are here that I was explaining to you when we were outside of the vessel. And those, these are all the screens and curtains and stuff, but those get tied in. right here into the hole itself. And then all of that, see that green cable? That right there is actually bonded down to the keel bolts. So again, there's just so much brought in to these vessels that are kind of above and beyond, but it's these small little attention to detail things that we really look out for. So here you can see these Bose speakers here. They're built onto this really nice woodwork. And then again, the forward bulkhead. And then this is the compression post for the mast. All LED interior lighting as well too. All right, so as we go to the forward V-berth coming through this door, we have the really nice forward V-berth, overhead opening hatch. They have screen shades on them. We also have a second television here. This is a large storage locker, and you can see all the manuals for the boat, which is really impressive in my opinion. Air conditioning vent as well too, so this allows you to have airflow up here. LED lights, and as you can see, this is a large berth. So obviously head up here, feet down there. There's little built-in nightstands, you know, behind your headrest there. And then behind here, this is a hanging locker. So great hanger locker. That is the mosquito screens for the overhead opening hatch here as well too. All right, so this will give us a nice profile view looking aft. Again, just this nice open feel. I love how they brought the compression post to this forward bulkhead so it's not right in the middle of the salon. Great seating, great attention to detail, so much natural light, you know, in the vessel itself. Down below, you know, the floorboards are just really nicely, you know, orientated in a sense with this, you know, horizontal grain pattern as well too, with these routered grooves, giving you a really nice open feel. Well, I hope you found this video to be helpful and informative. Hopefully you can see yourself in this vessel out in Catalina Island or sailing the coast of California. If you would like additional information or set up a time to view this in person, please feel free to contact myself at any time, day or night. My phone number is below. I look forward to hearing from you and hopefully earning your business. Thank you again.